Thank you very much. This is Dr. Fadil Abdallah working with the Ministry of Health, now coordinating the cholera elimination plan, shortly called the ZACCEPI in Zanzibar. I will be talking about the history of cholera Zanzibar, and then I will be talking about some plans for the ZACCEP, what have been planned in the program. And lastly, I will be talking about the exercise itself, what have been transpired during the exercise. Looking on the history of cholera in Zanzibar, you will see that the cholera, thank you very much, cholera has been introduced here in Zanzibar in 80s, 70s, up to 60s, up to 70s. But in the recent years, our first epidemic had been recorded here in 1978. After that, there were several epidemics followed, and so far we have documented about 19 to 20 major epidemics, apart from small epidemics. And most of these epidemics are usually happening just during or just after the Pyrenees season, and this is common in most of our countries. Looking on all of those epidemics, we'll see the case fatality rate ranging, the average case fatality rate is about 1.2%. And almost all of these epidemics are caused by O1, Vibrio cholera O1, Elta, Ogawa. And according to the records here, our very last epidemics was in 2019. Where we recorded about 136 cases, and there was no death. Next, please. In fighting the disease, in 2019, the government of Zanzibar under the Ministry of Health and Vice President Office have launched the cholera elimination plan, aiming at stopping the transmission of the disease among the population. So we developed this plan, which called Zanzibar Comprehensive Cholera Elimination Plan, which combines the WASH interventions together with case management and other preventive measure, including the providing the oral cholera vaccines. So the plan combines the strengthening WASH infrastructure, but also ensuring adequate supply of clean and safe water, improving surveillance of case and our water here, and lastly, most importantly, the providing oral cholera vaccines. And we have decided for effective coordination and partnership. All of this plan is under control and under the leadership of the Vice President Office. Next, please. Yeah, 2021 is not our first OCV campaign here in Zanzibar. The very first preventive OCV campaign in Zanzibar was conducted in 2009, where we by then targeted about 51,000 people to be vaccinated in six hotspot area. Here in Zanzibar, we called Shehias. And in that exercise, we provided the two doses of Dukoral. And in that exercise, about 57.9% of the population of target population was given both doses of the vaccine, and about 76% of the population or the targeted population was given the only one dose. Good thing is that for about 5 years after that exercise, we didn't record any epidemic until 2015, where a major epidemic occurred in Zanzibar. Next, please. Again, continue with the effort to eliminate disease here in Zanzibar. As I've said, in this year, July and August, we implemented our second oral cholera vaccine campaign, where we targeted population of 322,000 people to be vaccinated from 33 shehias, compared to 6 shehias, which was planned for last exercise. In this exercise, we provided 2 doses of Shanko and for all people aging 1 year and above, but we excluded the pregnant women. And you will see almost all districts of Zanzibar, except 2 districts only, have been involved in this exercise. And when looking on 2 big islands we are having here, Unguja and Pemba, the whole of seven districts of Unguja have been involved, but 2 districts of Pemba was excluded because of the lower number of cases in those districts. You will see in this exercise 2021, we opened about 215 posts. And about 1,500 people have been deployed during the exercise. This include the supervisors, vaccinators, community mobilizers, and others like those. Thank you, God. Next, please. Yes. Main objective of this exercise, of this campaign, is to cut the local transmission of cholera in the country. And actually the whole plan on cholera elimination here in Zanzibar mainly targeting on the hotspot area. So you'll see the OCV targeting the same area, WASH campaign mainly is targeting the same area. So our plan is mainly to start to, first of all, to cut this transmission in this area. But this will act also as a, this will also will provide the heart protection to entire population. We were aiming to vaccinate about 90% of the eligible population in those area. But as you will see there, we have vaccinated about 63% of the population for both doses. Another specific objective was to reduce cholera incidence, number of cholera incidents and number of cholera epidemic in the country, and at the same time to provide the breather period so that we can improve our washing situation in the country, improving the infrastructure for wash, and at the same time to continue the raising awareness on cholera prevention, particularly in the targeted population and the entire community. Next, please. Next. Yeah, and this is a result. We used about 500,000 doses of the vaccine, and at the end of this exercise, we managed to vaccinate 63.7% for both doses. But a good thing is that on the first round, we managed to vaccinate about 91.7%. But on the second dose, those who got both doses was about 63% only. And looking on the data, you will see mostly about 42% of the vaccinated were above 60 years old, and mostly female, which made about 64%. And on the right hand side, you will see the district coverage per each district, and including the doses used, the dropout together with the overall vaccination. And just recently, about 2 weeks ago, we have completed the post-coverage survey under the cooperation with the WHO and the CDC. We have included in this survey the WASH situation. And after a short time, you will see the result and will be shared with you. Next, please. And during the exercise, we didn't miss some hi-fi, people who got adverse effects. And we have recorded about 29 cases with hi-fi. Good thing is that most of them were mild hi-fis. 25 of them was found in the first round and 4 of them was found in second round. As I've said, 22 cases were mild cases, mainly vomiting, skin rashes, and body fatigue, with about 8 cases with mild to moderate symptoms, including dizziness, limb numbness, and chest tightness. And we had one, we can say severe, case of 2-year-old child who got severe vomiting, and then the vomiting followed by the blood vomiting until the kid got anemia and a severe anemia and had been treated at our main referral hospital here with the blood transfusion and luckily was discharged on the third day. But our physical examination showed that this kid has had other core diseases, and including malnutrition and other. So you can see until he got the severe bleeding, severe vomiting, and severe vomiting blood. But all other cases were mild and have been treated as OPD cases. On the right side here, you will see the
Doctor,
number of main symptoms.
We have some few time left.
Pardon. Yes.
Some few time
next,
left.
Please. Yeah, and these are the main ongoing intervention on WASH, particularly on the maintaining and intensifying the infrastructure, particularly in the urban and west region. And we are also working with the UNICEF and other organization to improve water quality in the area and continue with health education and hygiene in this area, particularly in the hotspots, together with the engagement of religious and community leaders and regular monitoring of water supply with our water authority here. Next, please. And lastly, the challenges. These are the challenges which have been experienced in this exercise. The first one is confusion between the OCV and the COVID-19 vaccine. As you can see, particularly in the second round, where unfortunately we started our second round about 3 days only just after the COVID-19 vaccine launching. So this affected a lot our exercise, and we had found low adherence to IPC protocol because of low number of COVID cases here in Zanzibar. So we have found a low adherence on IPC. And another challenge was on ICT because of the connectivity. It's particularly in remote areas where we were trying to use our tablets here recording, but unfortunately the connectivity was not that good. And as you know, inadequate WASH facility, particularly in the hotspot area. Another challenge was the wide.
Do you hear us?
Yes.
Okay, just to let you know, we are
finished. I'm just finished.
2 minutes. Okay, thanks so much.
Yes. Thank you. And another challenge was the wide gap between the when we requested the vaccine and when we started the vaccine. There was about 2 years gap there. No, that is 2019 and not 2009. And another challenge was insufficient capacity to store the vaccine, and what also people were coming from other area which were not targeted for vaccination and asking for vaccination in the targeted population or targeted area. Next, last one, please. Next, please. Hello. Yes, and this is the our forward. We are now continuing to intensify the social mobilization At the same time, we are trying now to plan ourselves to document and to do some researches on impact of OCV in this population. At the same time, to continue with community engagement on social mobilization, education, particularly on WASH, and engaging the different partners in strengthening the WASH situation in the whole of Zanzibar. And we are planning now in the next month, we are planning to use the remaining vaccine. We are about 169,000 of doses have been remained, and we'll be using this vaccine in other high risk area. And lastly, strengthening the cholera detection, particularly on surveillance, particularly in the district and health facility level. Thank you very much.